Hey everyone, I'm Melissa Thornley and I focus on leaders doing good in the world. And today I am here with Scott Marvel. Scott Marvel is from Daily Planet Productions and he also started an organization called Give a Shirt. And he's totally, Give a Shirt, see? There we go, hey. So today we are gonna talk about leadership and what makes Scott tick and what makes Give a Shirt such a successful organization. Thanks for joining us today, Scott.
You're welcome. I happen to be here.
Which is a good thing. Excellent. Yeah. So what's the mission of Give a Shirt?
We connect local artists design t-shirts. We hand screen them all. We sell them at pop-ups and online, and 100% of the profit goes to Streetwise. So it's art doing good for people in need in our community.
Art. Good people in need.
Right.
Three hot topics for you, right?
Right, right.
So how did you decide to start Give a Shirt?
Well, I had this t-shirt company and a guy down the street was shaking a cup outside of Starbucks. I was on my way to lunch. He said, I gave him some money. He said, can you do a little more for me? I've got a job interview in a couple days. He said, I need clothes. I need to buy some clothes for this job interview. I need to look presentable. I said, I've got a t-shirt company. I can give you, I'm thinking blank stock. I can get them wholesale stock. What's your size? He said, let me think about it. When I came back from lunch, he mistook it to mean I was going to make t-shirts for him to sell on the street. So he came up with the idea. And then from then on, that was years ago. From then on, I was thinking, how can I get t-shirts on the street that can do good?
Right.
And then we just came up with, someone was writing an article about companies doing charity work. And I said, I have this idea, but we haven't had time to put it together. And they said, you should do it. So I said, okay, we'll do it, print it. And in 3 weeks, we came up with Give a Shirt.
Ta-da!
Yeah.
Okay, so what are, hey, we've got some viewers out there. Thanks for joining us. So Scott, what have been some of the challenges in growing Give a Shirt?
Well, it's really a core of three people, my sister Pam, Janine, who works here, and myself. I print all the shirts. Pam folds and organizes all the shirts. Janine runs the website. And we've grown bigger and bigger and bigger. And we've made a lot of money for Streetwise. But that's not a lot of people to run a production shop and get shirts out to the public in a timely fashion. So that's been one of the hardest parts. Like just, and every year we have post-ops from the pop-up shops. And like, what did we do right? What did we do wrong? We look at it very critically, and it's gotten better and better, and this year ran really smoothly. Though there is always a point in my unfinished basement on the northwest side where there are tears shed, quite honestly, because we're printing 1,000 shirts, and the basement just explodes with shirts everywhere, and like, wait, what am I printing on this shirt? That sort of thing happens.
Yeah.
All the time, every year. It's, you don't want to see how the sausage is made.
Okay, we don't. Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
Especially vegan sausage.
Right.
I don't want to know about the vegan sausage.
Right, right. It's a little sawdust.
So what leadership qualities do you access? Like, what do you lean into? What qualities of yourself do you lean into to deal with these challenges?
Well, listening and patience and kindness and patience and patience and patience. A lot of that, because we're stressed out, quite honestly. And just listening to people and letting people do their jobs, you know, just giving them the freedom. And we just keep coming back to the core. We have to keep reminding ourselves, will this sell more shirts? Will this give more money to Streetwise? Will this raise awareness for Streetwise? Because that's the core. And you can lose your mission really fast. So it's important just to keep that in mind, that simple question that has to be put to every action.
Right.
Will this do good for Streetwise?
Right. So having a clarity of purpose, involving people and letting them use their talent and do good themselves,
right?
And listening to, you're not only listening to the artist, you're listening to the customers that are buying the shirts, you're listening to the Streetwise vendors and what they need, and the leaders at Streetwise also, I imagine.
Yeah. And as it started, you know, this was just a fun project. Like, let's get all of our friends that can make t-shirts, make some t-shirts, and we'll have a pop-up shop. That sounds like fun. And it is fun. But also, every year you kind of fall into this, you become more involved with Streetwise. You start to learn more about the vendors. I hate to say plight, but their path. You know, and they all recently were on the bottom and they're rising up, which is a great energy, right? Mm-hmm. And Streetwise gives them that power to have a job, a legal job, to sell magazines, to make money legally.
get a little closer. I think we're walking. Yeah,
yeah.
The world wants to see your face and your beard.
You might have to go super wide screen. Yeah, so learning more and more about the vendors has been an incredible thing, like to listen to their stories and to know them. And that's the one thing I want to say is if people want to buy a shirt, that's great, because it's a gift that gives and gives, right? If you buy it for yourself, you have a great shirt. But you also, 100% of the profit goes to Streetwise.
Yeah.
And their mission is amazing. They empower people to have a legal job. They also help people get financial support. They also help people expunge legal records, you know, for stupid stuff from years ago. They were trespassing, right, and now they can't get a job because if someone does a background check, they have something on their
record. Right.
So they help people a lot. They have fresh coffee and a meal for people every day at their Streetwise headquarters. They have internet service, a phone, just a place for people to hang out and have a community. And that's really cool.
Yeah, the community portion for sure.
Right.
And then the other thing that's cool about the shirts, we should probably, hey, look, there's a shirt right here. Uh-oh. So this one is designed by Carlos Reyes, called Hand in Hand. So check it out. Da, 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 da. And that says we plus R plus all plus equal, which is pretty cool. So a lot of the designs have a lot of fun messaging. They're beautiful designs by designers and artists across Chicagoland. Who are some of the people that have designed t-shirts for you?
Jeff Tweedy of Wilco.
Totally off screen
yeah,
now.
Yeah, sorry. Jeff Tweedy of Wilco. I keep thinking this is radio. Jeff Tweedy of Wilco, Jay Ryan of Bird Machine Press, mm-hmm. Nate Azark, who you know very well, 12 Line Studio, mm-hmm. Ben Klapik, Dan Jetza, Janine from our office did one, Johnny from our office did one, Matthew from our office did one. I throw in a designer too every year. What else do we have?
Look, and there's
Kareem Mock, Kara Hamilton, Ron Linneman, Kathleen Hinkle. Yeah, lots
we've got obviously our mugs and our very stylish and warm Thinsulate hats. Scott's is a little bit too tall to see.
Yeah, and this is a green one, which we're coming out with in a couple weeks. It's at the embroiderer right now.
Okay, and I'm just
the mug.
I'm gonna pull up one more shirt as long as we're here, and they're so colorful and beautiful. Alone together, which is pretty cool. Betty, hey, how are you? Betty is in Scotland. She's far away. And so what can people do to support Give a Shirt?
GiveAShirt.net. Go there.
GiveAShirt.net. Order, GiveAShirt.net. I'll put it in the comments.
Order 100 shirts. If you order more than one, or order more than two shirts, you get a mystery shirt. So if you order four shirts, you get two mystery shirts.
Oh, those mystery are some, shirt.
Those are some old designs that we had extras of.
Uh-huh.
So you don't know what you're getting, but you'll have an extra gift. And then also, if you're on the street and you see one shaking a cup, someone's shaking a cup, or you see a Streetwise vendor, even if you don't have a buck or two to give to them to buy the magazine, just talk to them. Ask them how they're doing. That's so important. Just to acknowledge them. To not let them be ghosts in your city, you know? Which I feel happens a lot. And I guess for good reason. If you and I walk to the metro right now, it's about a mile walk, we'd run into 20 people asking for something.
Yeah.
And we would probably, before this conversation, speed up and kind of just keep talking. But people need people, you know? And just say hi. Just ask how they're doing. That's as important or more important than money.
So there you go, folks. A few things that you can do to impact your community. Just say hi and acknowledge people that need other people. You can also get a shirt from GiveAShirt.net, or a hat or a mug. They're beautiful. And are you having any other pop-up shops that people in Chicago need to know about?
Yes. This weekend, Sunday at Twisted Hippo.
Twisted Hippo.
Brewing on Montrose. Okay. We'll be there from 12 to 6. They're having a holiday craft event. And then Low Res, Saturday and Sunday from, I think, 2 till 6.
Okay, great. So Low Res Brewery and Twisted Hippo, I will put this in the comments in the link. And thanks so much for taking time to think about how you can be a leader in your life, because we're all leaders in our lives, and we can all just take off a little chunk of something and do something good and make the world a better place. So thanks. Happy holidays, everyone.